first takeaway is you better be using scientific data. Okay. Let me cover that real quick with you. What are some of the common therapeutic protocols chiropractors use that is not scientific data? And again, when we say scientific based, because remember, you're going to be challenged in court. When we say scientific based, we're talking about peer-reviewed journal material, okay? So what are some of the common therapies and diagnostics that chiropractors use that are not scientific based? Neurokilometer. Subluxation station is a combination of three things, right? So neurokilometer, that's not scientific based. How intra-reliable testable is that, reliable is that?
Zero.
Thermography? Nope. It's not reproducible. You got to have the thermal paneling, the floor, the ceiling, the venting, the tester. It's not intra-tester reliable at all. Superficial NCVs? That's not scientific at all. Chiropractors doing superficial electrodiagnostics instead of needle EMG NCVs. That's not scientific at all. Is it thermography?
You're talking about like surface EMG?
Surface EMG. Yeah, okay. That's not scientific at all. Okay. What else chiropractors use? That's not scientific, you know, just kind of, it's like the chiropractic junk science. And, you know, to bill. And I mean, really, they do it just to bill. What else? Any other can you think of? Those are the big ones. Thermography, surface EMG, neurokilometer. Those are some of the big ones. I would not want to be the one in court trying to justify that with attorneys who know anything. And remember, once they get you in one area, you got any kind of a decent attorney, you want to just blow that up really big, and then you want to take that and throw it over the rest of your testimony and everything else. That's what you do. So that's what you don't want to do. That's why everything you do, you want it to be scientific based, so they can't challenge that.